these scientists calculated that the hands of the clock were about 2 minutes before midnight. We were that close. This was a time when we needed revolution. We required a revolution because we were hell-bent. The world was hell-bent for destruction. Srila Prabhupada came and brought the solution, Krishna consciousness. And for many of us, we immediately became attracted because we wanted a revolution. And we got it. And we began to spread it. And somehow or other, we cannot say, you know, maybe it is difficult to prove that the dissolution of the Soviet Union and other activities are connected to the spreading of Krishna consciousness in these areas. But the facts are there. The Hare Krishna movement is all over the former Soviet Union, and the former Soviet Union is no more. But we still are faced with so many challenges in this world. And unfortunately, people still do not understand that no matter what adjustments are made through the formula of secularism, there can be no solution without Krishna consciousness. Here in Sridham Mayapur, we have an opportunity to apply Krishna consciousness on a level that the world can see practical solutions to the problems that they face. We have a long ways to go in doing that. Perhaps we've also wasted some time not focused on this mission of creating an ideal place. When I first came here to Sri Mayapur Dham for service in 1976, I was brought to Srila Prabhupada's room, to your room, Srila Prabhupada. I'm reflecting. I hope that my memory is true. But by my memory, you were also reflecting on the state of the world at that time. And something in the news, something like today, we can reflect. Just, what was it, 2 days ago? The terrorist attack in Paris with 150 more people dying. So something like this had taken place. And you reflected that, yes, we may not expect that the whole world becomes Krishna conscious. That dream, that vision may be too much. But, he said, if there is one ideal place, there should be one ideal place. So Srila Prabhupada, I took this to mean your home, your place here in Sridham Mayapur. So perhaps we can all reflect today how much we are contributing, how much we are helping you to carry on your revolution. Now it is 50 years since you began this revolutionary movement in the Western world. It will be 50 years next year when you founded ISKCON with the first purpose to systematically propagate spiritual knowledge to society at large, and to educate all people in the techniques of spiritual life in order to correct the imbalance of values in life and to bring real unity and peace to the world. You gave us this mission. You gave us Sridham Mayapur to develop as an ideal representative of this amalgam of spiritual knowledge, spiritual techniques, a balance of values, a correct balance, and unity. Unity amongst people of various nations, various cultures, various genders, various ages, and of course, filled with the peace of knowing who we are, knowing what our purpose in life is, and being able to fulfill that purpose because you've given us everything we need to do that. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna.